Hello student, now in this lecture we have to see crystallography and some important basic terms in crystallography. Now see, first of all, crystallography. This crystallography is a branch of science which deals with the study of crystalline substances, particularly study of properties of crystal, then also study of geometry of crystal. Means the branch of science which deals with the study of geometry as well as properties and the structure of crystal and the crystalline substances is called as क्रिस्टलोग्राफी. जैसा कि आप लोगों को मालूम है, दिस इज क्यूब. ऑल साइड्स आर ऑफ इक्वल लेंथ. दिस इज क्यूब. अगेन यू नो दैट दिस क्यूब हैज दिस क्यूबिक ज्योमेट्री. ओके, एंड the study of such a crystal or crystalline substances under one special branch of science, that is crystallography. Crystallography includes the study of geometry as well as the structure as well as the characteristics of such a crystalline substances. Now the first term related to crystalline or crystallography is crystallographic faces or planes. Now, what is actually crystallographic face or plane? We know this is our cube. This is crystalline substance. Okay, all sides are of equal length. Okay, now here this is nothing but face. These are faces. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six faces are there or six planes are there. Now how we can define this each plane or face? This plane or face is a surface in which component particles or constituents are located and which defines the geometry of that crystal or that crystalline substance. Crystalline substance ka face ya plane matlab kya hota hai? Such a portion which contains these atoms or ions present in the crystal and which defines the geometry of that crystalline substances is called as a crystallographic face or crystallographic plane. Now, after this, second point is crystallographic axis or crystallographic edge. Now, suppose this crystal is taken. Now, in this crystal, this is crystallographic axis. X, this is Y, and this is Z. These are crystallographic axes or crystallographic edges. Now, see this crystallographic edge or axis. Now, here these two faces, this one face and this another adjacent face intersect at this point. Means crystallographic axis or edge is a line at which two adjacent faces intersects to each other. Intersects to each other. Now, for such a cubic crystal, देर आर थ्री एक्सेस एक्स वाई जेड. दिस एक्स एक्सेस इज अ लाइन ड्यू टू दिस प्लेन एंड दिस प्लेन. ओके दिस टू प्लेन्स दिस वन एंड दिस वर्टिकल दिस प्लेन दिस टू प्लेन्स एडजेसेंट प्लेन्स मीट अलोंग दिस लाइन. नाउ फॉर दिस दिस टू प्लेन्स ओके दैट्स व्हाई दिस आर एक्स वाई जेड आर क्रिस्टलोग्राफिक एक्सिस. नाउ नेक्स्ट वन इज क्रिस्टलोग्राफिक एंगल और इंटरफेशियल एंगल्स. नाउ सपोज वी हैव अगेन सेम क्रिस्टल. We are considering only cubic system. All edges are of equal length. X, Y, Z. These are the crystallographic axes. Now, in between X and Y, this is interfacial angle. This is alpha. In between Y and Z, this is beta. And in between Z and X, this angle is gamma. Now these alpha, beta, gamma are interfacial angles or one can say crystallographic angles. Now what is crystallographic angles or interfacial angles? The crystallographic angles or interfacial angles are defined as the angles at which the two faces meet. Do faces meet hote hai, that angle is nothing but interfacial angle. Okay, here one face, here this is second face, this meets here, this angle alpha is formed. Here in between Y and Z, this is beta, in Z and S, this is gamma. No doubt it is, these are different for different crystalline substances. Yahan par aapko cubic dikh raha hai to ye 90 90 90 hai sab. Okay, now lattice point, very important term. You know any crystal is made up from constituents, atoms or molecules. कोई भी सब्सटेंस का क्रिस्टल बनेगा तो वो उसके एटम्स या मॉलिक्यूल्स से बनेगा. Now, what is mean by lattice point? It is defined as the representation of position occupied by the constituent or the component particles in a crystal structure. It is known as a lattice point. Suppose we have this cubic crystalline system, and for such a cubic crystalline system, let me consider the eight atoms or ions are present at the eight corners of the cube. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. These are the constituent atoms or ions of the cubic system. They are present at the eight corners of this cube. Now, lattice point can be defined as the representation of the constituent atoms or ions or molecules present in our crystalline system. Getting it? Now this is called as lattice point. Now crystal lattice or a space lattice, it is defined as the representation of a set of lattice points repeated regularly in the three-dimensional space. Set of lines in three-dimensional space, these are the space lattice. 1, 2, suppose next crystal attached to it, okay, same type of crystal is there, then you may represent it in this way. Okay, now in this way, this is another, one can say crystal is there. Okay, same crystal is there, this is one, this is second. Okay, this is the set of points, equidistance, getting it? All these points, again representation at the corners. This crystallographic lattice or space lattice is a three dimensional arrangement, a regular arrangement of this space lattice in a space or in three dimension, that is crystal lattice can be defined as the representation of a infinite set of lattice points repeated regularly in three dimensional space. So it is an array of large number of lattice points. Now these space lattices may be are of three types: unidirectional lattice, bidirectional lattice, three dimensional lattice. Okay, first one A part, fifth mein B part or C part, unidirectional. Then bidirectional lattice point or unidirectional lattice or bidirectional lattice. Then bidirectional lattice, then three dimensional lattice. Now see one by one, what is meant by unidirectional? Arrangement of the constituents, atoms or ions, that is set of arrangement of the set of lattice points only in one direction. Suppose it is x axis, then this arrangement of the lattice point only in one directional, it is called as a unidirectional lattice. Now arrangement of the constituents or set of points in two direction, this is x axis, this is y axis, okay, this is called as a bidirectional. Now three dimensional lattice, arrangement of the constituent atoms or ions along three dimension, this is called as a what we can say, three dimensional lattice points. Okay, in this way 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, okay, ye aisa jo crystal rahega isme jo arrangement hoti hai, that arrangement is a three dimensional arrangement. Okay, x y z, yahan par hai, 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 yahan par hai point, yahan par hai, yahan par hai. Okay, means the arrangement of the constituents or set of space lattice along three dimensional axis is a three dimensional lattice. Now after this, the sixth term is lattice planes. अभी क्रिस्टल देखा अपन ने, क्रिस्टल कैसे बनता है, प्लेन्स से, फेसेस से, ओके, एजेस से, एंगल से, पॉइंट से. सपोज दिस इज आवर क्रिस्टल. नाउ दिस क्रिस्टल इज मेड अप फ्रॉम दिस सिक्स फेसेस. इट कंटेन्स दिस एट कंस्टिट्यूएंट्स एटम्स एट द eight corners of the cube. Okay, there are alpha, beta, gamma as interfacial angles. Okay, now we have to see sixth point, that is lattice planes. Kisko bolenge lattice planes? Jo plane containing lattice point. Means lattice planes can be defined as the planes parallel or equidistant to each other containing lattice points. Parallel and equidistant, these are called as a lattice plane. Suppose consider this plane. Now this plane and this plane, these planes are lattice planes. Why? Because these also contains the lattice points, these also contains the lattice points. They are at a equidistant, they are at a fixed distance. This plane also lattice plane, they contain lattice points, they also contain lattice point, and there is a fixed distance between them. In this way, such a planes which containing lattice points or constituents and they are at equidistance are called as lattice planes. Now seventh and very important term is that यूनिट सेल, वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट यूनिट सेल. नाउ बिफोर दिस यू मस्ट नो क्रिस्टल. क्या होता है क्रिस्टल? क्रिस्टल इज नेचुरली ऑकरिंग सॉलिड विच हैव फ्लैट फेसेस, शार्प एजेस एंड डेफिनेट इंटरफिशियल एंगल्स. क्रिस्टल मतलब दूसरा तीसरा कुछ भी नहीं. क्रिस्टल मतलब क्या होता है? एक क्रिस्टलाइन सब्सटेंस होता है कि जिसको फ्लैट फेसेस होते हैं, ऐसे शार्प एजेस होते हैं, डेफिनेट इंटरफिशियल एंगल्स होते हैं, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज अ क्रिस्टल. ओके, नाउ लेट मी अज्यूम दिस इज अ क्यूब, ऑल साइड्स आर ऑफ इक्वल डिस्टेंस, दैट्स व्हाई वी डिवाइड इट इन दिस वे. यहां से अपन ने ऐसा कट करने के लिए एक प्लेन डाल दिया कि जो प्लेन एग्जैक्टली इसको दो पार्ट में डिवाइड करेगा. इधर से भी डाल दिया, इधर से भी डाल दिया. ओके, अभी ये देखने के बाद में, ये बनाने के बाद में अपन ने एक पूरा क्रिस्टल लिया था. ये क्रिस्टल कौन सा था? क्यूब था. मतलब आपको उसकी ज्योमेट्री पता थी, ऑल साइड्स आर ऑफ इक्वल लेंथ. हर एक का सेंटर लेके अपन ने ऐसा प्लेन कट किया उसको. ओके, इक्वल एंड अपोजिट साइड्स. और इसमें से एक छोटी वाली चीज को अपन ने उठा लिया. इट विल बी लुक्स लाइक्स इन दिस वे. ओके, इसको चार बार, एक बार इधर से रखो, एक बार इधर से रखो, एक बार इधर से रखो, फोर टाइम्स रिपीट करो तो क्या बनेगा? क्रिस्टल, क्यूबिक क्रिस्टल. दिस इज स्मॉलेस्ट बिल्डिंग यूनिट. दिस रिपीटेड फोर टाइम्स, देन यू विल गेट क्रिस्टल. सच अ स्मॉलेस्ट बिल्डिंग यूनिट ऑफ अ क्रिस्टल इज नथिंग बट यूनिट सेल. समझ में आया? यूनिट सेल और क्रिस्टल में एक ही डिफरेंस होता है. ये जो क्रिस्टल का एक्स एक्सिस है, सपोज ये है 10 सेंटीमीटर, अपन ने इसके चार डिवीजन किए हुए, मतलब ये रहेगा 5 सेंटीमीटर. ओके, इसका एंगल 90, ये भी 90, इसका ये बीटा 90. ओके, मीन्स यूनिट सेल कैन बी डिफाइंड एज the smallest geometrical portion of the crystal which is repeated number of times in a crystal and it represents the geometry of a geometry or shape or faces or symmetry and angles but not only size. ye dono mein difference kya hai? sirf size ka hai. ये रिप्रेजेंट करता फेस, इसको भी फेस है, पॉइंट्स पॉइंट्स भी है, एजेस भी है, सेम इंटरफिशियल एंगल्स है, एक्सेप्ट दीज टू आर डिफरेंट फ्रॉम ईच अदर ओनली ड्यू टू साइज. सच अ यूनिट सेल कैन बी डिफाइन एज इट इज द स्मॉलेस्ट ज्योमेट्रिकल पोर्शन ऑफ द क्रिस्टल विच रिपीटेड नंबर ऑफ टाइम्स इन अ क्रिस्टल and which represent faces, edges, interfacial angles, other than size, all the properties represented by such a cell is called as a unit cell. Now here we come to know about such a 7 important points in the crystallography. First of all, crystallographic faces, then crystallographic edges, then crystallographic angles, then lattice points, then space lattice. Space lattice mein teen cheeze, unidirectional, bidirectional, three dimensional. Then chhata point, lattice planes, and last and very important point, that is unit cell. Here the basic terms are now over. Now we have to see some important aspect of crystallography we will see in the next period, that is symmetry and symmetry elements. Okay, I think you all getting this. Try to understand. If any difficulty, ask me anytime. Thank you. Thank you very much.